this is Overpass Insights. My name is Eric and I make apps. Now, my fellow developers, stop complaining about deadlines. All right, so it's been a while since I've done a video, at least a couple of weeks. And one of the reasons is that last week I came down with COVID, right? After 2.5 years, my number finally came up. I mean, hundreds of thousands, millions of people have had it. You may have had it, right? And I finally got it last week. So my energy levels were just nowhere. Like, I had difficulty working. I fell behind on a lot of stuff. It was just, you know, it just kind of sucked. And I'm still testing positive, so I'm still isolating. I'm still stuck in this flat, but I'm stuck in this apartment, for those of you guys who are not in England. But I'm feeling a lot better. My energy levels are back up. Last week, mostly what I did was sleep. I was like isolating, because so I kept thinking, maybe I should do a video. And then my next thought was, so anyway, it feels really good to get the energy levels back. Anyway, so last week I was looking through LinkedIn. I was, you know, scrolling through LinkedIn posts, which is not something I normally do. It is my least favorite social network, right? It seems like a lot of people, like, LinkedIn always seems very spammy to me, like, you know, people trying to sell to each other and all this kind of stuff, but it is what it is. It's a useful tool. We use a lot for prospecting, checking up on clients, that kind of stuff, and it's like, you know, kind of one of those things you have to do. Anyway, I saw this post on there by a developer who said, I hate to think of all the software projects that have been ruined by deadlines. And it was like it was an interesting post that I thought about it. And I thought, this is a junior developer. This is someone new to the game. This is someone who's, you know, who still thinks that deadlines are a bad thing, right? Because, by the way, as a software developer myself, I hate deadlines. Deadlines suck. Especially when you have a project where you're giving a quote, or, you know, ideally the deadline is based on the estimates that you're given. You know, if you've ever had a manager that says, like, who thinks they're being all bravado by saying, how long is it going to take you? He said, I don't know, it'll take me, you know, a week. And they go, you got 3 days, right? You're like, well, you know, it doesn't work that way. Despite what you've seen in the movies, you don't just go in there and go, you got 2 hours, get going. Right, so as a developer, a lot of times, if you get a deadline that is contrary to what your estimates are, you have to push back. It's just one of those things. You have to make sure that everybody knows that, you know, why your estimate is what it is. But anyway, but other times, you'll give an estimate because you have to give some sort of estimate, even though you're not quite sure. Like, there might be an issue that's still an unknown, like if it's a bug fix, for example, or if it's something where technologically you're not quite sure how it's going to work, or, you know, there's some APIs you still need to investigate. There's all kinds of things that you might not be able to give an estimate as good as you can, but then you do. And then once that estimate is there, once that deadline is there, then the stress sets in. Then you got to get everything done. You got to, you know, make sure everything is done right. And if you start to run out of time, you'd be like, okay, ideally, I would love to do X, Y, and Z, but really what we need to do we just need to get this out and going, so we'll just do, you know, X and Y, but we'll leave Z off or whatever. Usually the things that get sacrificed are like unit tests and proper testing and stuff like that. But sometimes, you know, well, testing has to happen, right? You don't put something out there without testing. But, you know, and testing is one of those things that will grow, it will expand and contract based on the time you give it, right? It's Parkinson's law. Parkinson's law says work expands or retracts based on the time you give it, which is one of the reasons why we need deadlines, right? The guy who said this, I think of all the projects that that have suffered because of deadlines, I think of all the software projects that have never been completed because there was no deadlines. I mean, personally, I've had so many projects over the years, which I started on my own applications, where I didn't give myself a deadline, and just, you know, other things came up, or, you know, another idea comes up, or another feature idea, or just, you know, you get that bit where you don't have something set in stone where you have to get something out there, and it doesn't. This is one of the big problems I have with client work, is that we'll have something where they'll have a tight deadline. So if we have an event, like a trade show or something like that, and we're doing an app for a trade show, those apps are so stressful, but they're so ideal because you know that they're gonna get finished. You know that it's not going to be with a client testing forever. You know, they have a deadline, you have a deadline. It's not just a deadline imposed on you or a deadline imposed on them. It's a hardcore deadline. And other times you'll have somebody where the client will say, oh, we need it by this date. And then when you give it to them, they say, ooh, we also want this, this, and this. And you're going, well, that first of all, that wasn't in the specification. And secondly, there's no way we could do that with your deadline. And then it's like, oh, well, we could push back the deadline. And then it becomes this thing where, you know, when you're actually charging for that work, you need to get paid for it. So you need that deadline set in stone. One of my favorite TED Talks, which I talk about all the time, is, I can't remember his name, but it's called Confessions of a Master Procrastinator. And I'll put a link to it in the description, because if you haven't seen it, it's really, really good. And in it, he talks about the mind of a procrastinator. And in some ways, we're all procrastinators. And he talks about all, you know, when he talks about getting over procrastination and actually delivering something, he talks about all the people who have contacted him in real, like, with shame in their voice and everything. Or they're so disappointed in themselves because they didn't complete something because they never gave themselves a deadline. We all have these things where we want to do one day. I want to write a book. I want to do videos. I want to release this app. I want to do whatever. And with no deadline in place, it becomes that thing that's always on the horizon, always that thing that you're going to do. For me, it's travel. Like, I'm starting to realize that my excuses for not traveling they're starting to dwindle, and I'm kind of still holding on to them, like, oh, well, I'll wait till COVID's completely over, I'll wait till this, whatever. And then there's this thing where it's like, dude, I got to put a deadline in place. I'm getting older, you know, we got to do this kind of stuff, so. Anyway, the point of this video is that deadlines are a fact of life. In fact, if you don't have a deadline, you know, it's a lot less stressful if you don't have a deadline on a software project. But it is like the odds of you actually getting it done are, you know, going to be much higher if you have one. And the hard thing is when you set it, when you set a deadline that is fungible, that is changeable, like your client sets one or that you set one for yourself, and you're like, oh, well, instead of releasing it this week, I'll release it 2 weeks from now. Or, you know, next month's just as good as this month, whatever. Then that gets dangerous too, right? The hard bit is when you set your own deadlines and you don't stick to them. Anyway, I just thought I'd, you know, share my thoughts on that. I hope you guys are having a great week. I hope you guys are healthy. I hope, you know, stay away from this virus if you haven't caught it yet. That is it for today. I'll talk to you guys again next time.